Edmonton, it's devastating. You can't lose a home game right now this time of year. That's the situation when you're fighting for your lives. You cannot lose a home game. And for them to blow that one last night, get down 2-0, and then to play the way they've played the last four, it's youth. It's too much youth, and it's veterans that are giving them nothing. I mean, look at their veterans. I mean, Hemsky, one goal, I believe, in his last 19 games.
Yeah.
Smith, two goals this year. Horcroft doesn't do very much. I mean, you look at their veteran group. I mean, if they don't fix that veteran group somehow, they're not going to make it next year. That's how frightening it is.
That's a tough situation to be in as a GM. One of the things about that team is it's been generally the same managerial team forever. You know, it's one long line. Do they need to blow that all up?
Well, they probably won't because, you know, they've got a general manager in Tambellini who's a great guy, but Kevin Lowe is really the general manager, mm-hmm. and he's in tight with the owner, so I don't see that happening. And it seems, you know, that you're right, it's been there forever. And, you know, I guess there's loyalties. I mean, they gave Hemsky 2 years at $5 million, which means he has another $5 million next year on his deal. And I mean, I couldn't believe they didn't try to give him away at the deadline just to change the culture. But here's the challenge: it's not easy to get veterans to go there. When you have your pick of where to go as a veteran player, and usually there's three or four or five teams that are pursuing you, you know, unfortunately they don't pick Edmonton, an unbelievably great hockey city, but it's not number one on a lot of teams' lists, a lot of players' lists.
You know what, though, Mac? It's interesting about that because you're right about the veterans. We know the story with Pronger and was it Nylander, I think, that signed there and then begged out. But Justin Schultz had his pick of the litter, and he went there because he looked at it as they got a lot of really good young talent. I'll fit in. We'll win a lot of cups. Well, obviously that's changing now, but it is an interesting perspective that, you know, some people, the guys who've been around the league, don't want to go, even though it sure looks like that should be a team you'd want to be with for the next 5-10 years.
Well, if you're a young guy like Schultz, it made sense. You know, it really made sense to get in with that group of four or five guys and build together and grow together. And I think that's the selling feature. But the challenge is when you've got a Ryan Clough and a David Clarkson, and you've got you know, Stephen Weiss, and you've got Mike Ribeiro, and you've got Derek Roy as some of your premier free agents. Name me one of those guys that's going to sign in Edmonton.
Yeah, you're right. They,
that's the challenging part, and it's not an easy job for them. I empathize with them because I was in the same boat in Columbus, and the only way we got Adam Foote or Todd Marchand or any of those guys to come there is you had to overpay them.